Hello and a warm welcome to everyone. In this edition of BIS Talk, we seek to explore the standardization activities of one of the most important divisions of the Bureau of Indian Standards, the Civil Engineering Department, or CED. Look around yourself and think. Take a look at all the spaces that enrich our lives, our homes, our workspaces and markets, everything between the walls. The spaces where we live, work, entertain, worship, where we dream and celebrate. I believe these spaces are vibrant metaphors of the progress of any civilization. That's because their quality determines our quality of living. That brings us to the core agenda of CED. This department of BIS seeks to enhance quality of life by setting standards for our living spaces and infrastructure. Now let's get to know more about the agenda of the CED by the head of the Civil Engineering Department.
The two pillars of development are land development and building construction. These in turn require sound standards for all external development of built environment and for buildings. BIS has formulated around 1800 standards to cover aspects of planning, building design, building materials, construction and maintenance of the assets so created. The main objective is to provide minimum benchmarks of quality and safety. BIS has been continuously on the job to create standards in tandem with the research institutions, manufacturers, user departments and agencies, academic institutions and various subject experts who are all on the BIS technical committees chaired by experts of eminence. In the process, BIS has formulated a series of standards on building orientation, lighting and ventilation, acoustics, and for accessibility of buildings and built environment for persons with disabilities and the elderly, on building materials and components, on various loading codes and structural design codes using various material streams for safe design of structures, on good construction practices, including safety during construction and construction project management, and on disaster-resistant design of structures, including man-made disasters due to fire or natural disasters like earthquakes, cyclones, and landslides. Finally, the standards on smart and sustainable development. In addition, there are special publications including the National Building Code of India, which supplements the efforts of these standards. Standardization is a dynamic process, and all standards are reviewed periodically, and if required, revised or amended from time to time. All stakeholders should copiously refer and use these standards for ensuring orderly, safe, accessible and sustainable development for transforming our rural and urban habitats. Let's now hear from Chairman of the Civil Engineering Division Council of BIS, Shri H.S. Dogra, about the vision and mission of the Council.
As you are aware, our country is on the path of rapid development. Large number of buildings and infrastructure projects are going on. It is therefore utmost important that quality is ensured of all these projects. This in turn requires input materials of a high quality and sound construction practice need to be observed. As chairman of this council, our main role is to oversee the work of these sectional committees. Work of these committees are periodically reviewed to ensure that adequate representation of various stakeholders is available in the committees. The committees are also provided guidance wherever required in deciding their plan of action as well as for strengthening with appropriate domain experts. Council also oversees and guides the international participation of engineers in ISO for development of international standards in civil engineering. Our focus is now on all those standards which affect the attainment of 17 sustainable goals laid down by the United Nations General Assembly and are adopted by our country. Our country has committed to substantially achieve these goals by 2030. In pursuance of these goals, BIS has taken up formulation of standards for smart cities, wastewater recycling, water efficient fittings, geopolymer concrete, performance based building components, new housing technologies, etc. more and more subjects for standards are approved apart from approving and updating various standards. As chairman of the Civil Engineering Council, I seek the support of all the professionals, including experts and R&D, researchers, academic institutions, etc., to assist BIS in this national effort.
For the process of rural development and urbanization to be transformative and sustainable, high quality standards need to be followed in each one of these areas. Now let's move ahead and look at some of the areas in which standards are formulated by the CED. To start with, we have planning. It goes without saying that planning is an integral component of building construction. This ensures factors like proper lighting, ventilation, circulation spaces, open spaces in and around the building, building orientation, and accessibility for persons with disabilities and the elderly. Here is a list detailing some of the planning-related standards. Once you have the plan ready, the next critical step is to design the structure.
The structural design is to be carried out to withstand various loads to which buildings are subjected during their service life. These are dead loads, imposed loads, wind loads, snow loads, and some special loads. They are detailed in the loading codes IS 875 part 1 to 5. Dead loads are due to weight of different parts of the structure itself. IS 875 part 1 gives methods for estimating dead loads based on unit weight of materials and of miscellaneous materials. Imposed loads are caused due to occupants and movable objects like furniture, machinery, and due to impact. Part 2 of IS 875 specifies the imposed loads for design purposes. IS 875 Part 3 gives estimation of wind loads based on the prevailing wind speed zones denoted as basic design wind speed. It also takes into account factors such as size and height of a building and closeness with other buildings. IS 875 Part 4 covers estimation of loads due to snow as prevalent in many hill districts frequented by snowfall in the country. The estimation of earthquake forces is covered in IS 1893 Part 1. This standard guides in structural design considering the seismic vulnerability, soil type, importance and type of structural systems. A judicious combination of all these loads as also some special loads such as temperature and vibration loads are covered in IS 875 Part 5.
This covers design of both traditional and modern buildings with design codes dedicated to a vast variety of material streams including masonry, timber, bamboo, plain and reinforced concrete, pre-stressed concrete, steel or of modern prefabricated and pre-engineered and glass facade buildings. Here is a list of key standards for structural design. It's time to now dig a little deeper into this very important aspect of building and infrastructure construction. You must have heard of the notion, you can't build a great building on a weak foundation. This is a reality. Now let's go to our expert who will throw some more light on this subject.
Design of foundation for buildings and structures has to begin with proper subsurface investigation and assessment of bearing capacity of soil. This is followed by detailed design and construction of foundations. A series of standards has been made available to cover all these and allied areas. IS 1892 provides good practices for subsurface investigation for buildings and other infrastructure works. The methods of subsurface investigation enable vertical sections of the strata to be drawn and samples to be tested on the site or in a laboratory for determining shear strength parameters, bearing capacity of the soil, permeability, water table, type classification, and other geophysical information in the field. This information, together with the normal topographical survey, provides the engineer with complete details of the site and enables him to prepare safe and economical designs for the foundations. Foundations can be cello foundations, deep foundations or special foundations. Pile foundations are deep foundations principally used to transfer the loads from superstructures through weak compressible strata or water onto stronger, more compact, less compressible and stiffer soil or rock at depth, increasing the effective size of a foundation and resisting horizontal loads. BIS has therefore formulated IS 2911 on design and construction of pile foundations in different parts and sections. Part 1 of IS 2911 covers various types of concrete piles in its four sections. Section 1 covers driven cast in situ concrete piles. Section 2 covers board cast in situ concrete piles. Section 3 covers driven precast concrete piles. Section 4 covers precast concrete piles in pre-board holes. Part 2 of IS 2911 covers timber piles. Part 3 covers underreamed piles and Part 4 covers load test on piles. Together, the above series of standards ensure safe design and construction of pile foundations for buildings and other structures.
Before we move on to the next segment, let me show you two maps that directly connect to the structural design of buildings and other structures. These are about two forces of nature that cannot be overlooked while planning any building structure anywhere. The seismic zoning map of India brought out by BIS, as per which the parts of the country are categorized into four earthquake zones: zone 2, 3, 4, and 5 in order of increasing severity. The map also reveals that around 60% of Indian landmass is prone to earthquakes. The standards specified by BIS enable design and construction of buildings and structures, ensuring safety against earthquakes likely to occur at the location of the structure. Standards related to this include also take a look at wind zoning map of India brought out by BIS, as per which parts of the country are categorized into six basic wind speed zones. This includes coastal areas which experience very high and cyclonic winds. This aspect has been covered in a focus standard, IS 875 Part 3, dealing with wind loads. There are a few other standards dealing with cyclone resistant designs which are listed here. We will talk in further detail about safety against natural disasters. For now, let's go back to yet another key aspect of buildings, shall we? The quality of a building or a structure depends on the quality of the building materials used in them. Setting standards for them becomes even more important since they are responsible for a substantial amount of investment in the overall cost of any structure.
There are over 1500 standards on various building materials prescribing their quality, performance, packing and marking requirements.
Among others, they cover standards for all major building materials used in construction activities, ranging from cement, concrete, building stones, wood products, sanitary appliances and pipes, and so on and so forth. Now let's go to our expert who will throw some more light on this subject.
For the selection of any building material for a specific type of construction, it is very important to know about their engineering properties like mechanical, chemical and thermal properties. BIS has therefore formulated different Indian standard specification on building materials like cement, aggregate, reinforcement bars, ceramic tiles, concrete tiles, paver blocks, timber, bamboo, flush door, plywood and other panel products and other flooring, wall finishing and roofing materials. For example, IS 15622 Indian Standard Specification for Pressed Ceramic Tiles. This standard covers glazed as well as unglazed ceramic tiles of modular and non-modular sizes. These tiles are further classified on the basis of their property of water absorption, like less than 3%, 3 to 6%, 6 to 10% and more than 10%. Other physical properties like modulus of rupture, moisture expansion, scratch hardness, thermal shock resistance and chemical properties like resistance to stain, household chemicals, acid, alkalis, etc. are covered in the standard. These properties are helpful to the user in selection of tiles as per their requirement. Apart from quality of materials, good construction practices also play an important role in overall construction quality. BIS has therefore formulated many Indian standards as code of practices for installation, erection and laying of various building materials and components. For example, IS 1443, Code of Practice for Laying and Finishing of Cement Concrete Tiles. In this Indian standard, use of different materials of required quality, method of preparation of mortar, laying of tiles, skirting, grinding, polishing and subsequent maintenance has also been detailed, which are helpful for proper laying performance during their use.
We can surely say in this area, nothing is left to chance. Let me now list out some important standards in this domain. After ensuring conformity of their products to the concerned Indian standard, BIS grants license to building material manufacturers under the BIS certification mark scheme. Only after acquiring this license, they are allowed to use the BIS standard mark, popularly known as ISI mark. Before we move any further into any other operational area of civil engineering, I would like to take you to a factory to see the actual process of manufacturing, testing and ISI marking of representative building materials.
We are producing 500 meter cube AAC block over here and we have certified with the ISI marker and we are following the IS code 2185 and manufacturing the best quality of product and it is well accepted in the market. We are following the national as well as the international standard and here we have a very good laboratory for the quality control purpose and it is totally fully automated plant.
Moving on from building materials, BIS has also formulated standards on special structures.
The structural design ensures that a structure has sufficient strength, adequate ductility and under external loads can remain as one integral unit. This assumes significant importance in case of special structures like chimneys, bins and silos, cell structures, water tanks, cooling towers, tall building, composite construction and transmission line towers, for all of which there exist design standards. These form the backbone of infrastructure development of the country. As the buildings are growing taller and taller, the new standard IS 16700 needs special emphasis for its use in design of tall buildings of height up to 250 meters and beyond. The standard is based on the prescriptive approach covering design aspects like selection of appropriate structural system, geometric proportioning of building, integrity of a structural system, resistance to wind and earthquake effects. It also provides for constitution of tall building committee for code exceeding tall buildings and lays down the procedures for design and approval process of such buildings. The Indian Standard on Cooling Towers, IS 11504, essentially deals with the safety concepts, structural design and construction consideration of reinforced concrete hyperbolic natural draft cooling tower. Provisions of the standard are applicable to all common cooling tower shapes formed by conic sections. The tower design consideration includes size and shape, spacing among towers, tower cell analysis, cell supporting structures and foundation and auxiliary structures.
Now for a few other crucial things important for modern living, like water for drinking and other purposes, efficient drainage system and sanitation facilities in buildings that are essential to ensure the hygiene and health safety of people. BIS has formulated a series of Indian standards to cover all these important areas. Efficient execution has to match good intentions, which means good planning and structural design aren't enough. It's also of utmost importance that the actual execution at site follows best practices. With this in mind, BIS has formulated a series of Indian standards on good construction practices. A few of them are listed here. Construction project management has emerged as an effective tool for quality construction. It helps prevent accidents at site and time and cost overruns. Standards of various operational areas of construction project management are handled by the multiple parts of IS 15883. Here's a complete list. That apart, IS 16416 gives the specifics for project formulation and appraisal of construction project management. The building structure is ready, but without proper maintenance, it's likely to lose its structural integrity and best functional abilities soon. Adequate and efficient maintenance of buildings and its various engineering services ensure continued durability, long life, and service life of the built facility. A number of standards have been developed to address this concern. As we all know from experience, construction activities are also prone to various hazards and accidents. This often leads to loss of life, property, and endangers investment if due care is not taken. BIS has therefore brought out a series of safety codes to be followed during various stages and activities during construction. Fire is a significant hazard for buildings. I believe this important area needs further detailing. Fire safety demands streamlined fire prevention strategies. This could be ensured through passive means, facilitating evacuation during fire and fighting the fire through portable and fixed fire fighting installations. BIS has formulated a series of fire safety codes for various types of buildings and for firefighting equipment, including fire extinguisher. Now you are seeing a detailed list of fire safety standards of various building types with various functions. Did you know that India remains one of the most disaster-prone countries in the world? Believe it or not, more than 50% of our people live in areas vulnerable to natural calamities of one type or the other. Without addressing this concern, no building or structure could be considered safe in India. We need standards that ensure our safety against natural disasters like earthquakes, cyclones, and landslides. Keeping this in mind, BIS has formulated a series of standards in the areas of earthquake engineering and cyclone-resistant design of structures. These we have already discussed while talking about structural designs. Now let's go to our expert who will throw some more light on this subject.
Hill areas in the country are experiencing rapid urbanization and development activities during last two decades. Unplanned activities have been mainly responsible for the increased incidence of landslide. BIS has therefore formulated a series of standards such as on landslide control, retaining wall, landslide zonations and risk assessment maps. One such standard is IS-14680 on landslide control. It covers landslide classification on the basis of five principal type of mass movement such as faults, toppling, slides, lateral spread, flow and a combination of two or more of these principal types of movement. It also recommended remedial measures of landslide prevention. Retaining wall play a major role in prevention of landslide. BIS has formulated a series of standards as IS-14458 Part 1 to Part 6 for selection, design and construction of various type of retaining walls. Further, the Indian standard IS-14496 Part 1 and 2 for landslide hazard zonation mapping is quite essential for identifying the areas with minimum landslide hazards.
After that brief outing to the hills, now back to the cities. As we all know, rapid urbanization is the call of the hour today. This, however, also raises concerns. Development, if not done properly, may lead to issues like environmental degradation and consequently have an adverse impact on the health and quality of life. To address this issue, BIS has embarked upon formulation of standards on sustainable development and developed various indicators for the same. Smart cities act as an aid to sustainable development. BIS has framed and is working on standards for smart and resilient cities, smart transportations, smart parking lot allocation, among many others. We did look at lots of areas till now in this edition of BIS Talks. Most areas are directly connected to civil engineering, but that's not all that CED handles. Construction workers are the vital force that make construction possible. Their safety and security is also given prime importance. Housing provided to construction workers as part of the employment contract should meet certain minimum requirements in respect of the nature and standard of the accommodation and facilities to be made available. BIS has formulated a standard, IS-16601, on habitat and welfare requirements of construction workers, which enumerates the essential habitat requirements of construction workers like well-lit and well-ventilated dwelling space, sanitation and healthcare, water including drinking water provisions, childcare facilities and security of lives and properties. Standards are not just meant to serve the well-to-do sections of the society. We also have standards that are specific to benefit the economically weaker sections.
Affordable housing is a necessity to help bring housing within reach of all, including economically weaker sections of the society. BIS has formulated a standard as 8888 that provides a guide for planning such as layout pattern, plot area, density, building height and community open space. It also prescribes general building requirements of low-income housing for various parts of building, including requirements of lighting and ventilation and sanitation facilities. To fulfill the needs of speeder building construction, BIS has come up with a standard IS-15916. The standard covers provision regarding modular planning, component sizes, prefabrication systems, design considerations, joint and manufacture, storage, transportation and erection of prefabricated concrete elements. It also gives design requirements to help prevent any progressive collapse of such buildings.
By now, being a stakeholder, you must also be wondering, where do you get all your information from? We did provide you with some inputs here, but this might not be specific to your queries, right? Simple. Just refer to the National Building Code of India, also called the NBC. This comprehensive publication has answers to all your queries. And we also have an NBC expert with us who will educate us more.
National Building Code of India, or NBC, the Building Code for the Nation, is the prestigious special publication of BIS. The code was first formulated at the instance of Planning Commission in 1970 and subsequently revised in 1983, 2005 and 2016. NBC 2016 has been brought out by the National Building Code Sectional Committee CED 46 through its 22 expert panels involving around 1,000 experts. It reflects the state-of-the-art and most modern provisions for building planning, structural design, and various building and plumbing services. The code deals with administrative and technical provisions such as development control rules, general building requirements, building materials, structural design, and services essential for sustainable land development and building construction. It is used by the building regulatory departments to frame their building bylaws, by the government construction department and private construction agencies in their construction activities, and by building professionals like architects, civil and structural engineers, town planners, building services engineers, landscape architects in their professional practice, by academic institutions for imparting technical education in architecture and civil engineering. An exclusive session of BIS Talks on NBC is also available. Get to know more insights about the code from it.
Apart from the NBC, the Civil Engineering Department of BIS has come up with various special publications addressing the concerns of specific key areas within the domain of civil engineering. We bring you a representative list here. The Indian standards in civil engineering formulated by BIS form an integral part of technical education imparted by IITs, NITs, state engineering colleges, and private institutions. The most important ones are related to planning, structural design, construction practices and management, and those relating to fire and life safety, lighting and ventilation, engineering services and plumbing services like water supply, drainage and sanitation. Key standards used in academics are IS 456, the Concrete Code, IS 800, the Steel Design Code, the earthquake codes like IS 1893 and IS 13920, the National Building Code.
In the development of building structures and facilities, five tenets of quality need to be adhered to. These are safety, functionality, sustainability, aesthetics, and economy. The Bureau of Indian Standards has developed numerous standards which provide a fine balance of these five tenets. Students, the future architects and civil engineers, learn the seriousness of their profession from the early days in their lives, from when the importance of these minimum essentials is emphasized through the daily use of standards in the classrooms. Therefore, standards are made a mandatory part of technical education at the bachelor's, master's, and doctoral levels. Also, each course in architecture and civil engineering degree programs brings a few of the standards into focus for students.
With impeccable standards, BIS aspired to be at the heart of every structure of urban and rural India, keeping you safe, secure and comfortable. By creating a safe, accessible and sustainable built environment, giving us Indians the quality of life we deserve.
Not only BIS ensures compliance of available standards, we also continuously work to bring new topical areas under the fold of standardization to keep pace with the requirements in various fields. Some of such areas are listed here for your ready reference.
It's only through strict adherence to standards in civil engineering we will be able to build the cities of today that fearlessly embrace our tomorrow. We have to do this for India, for every Indian, and we have to do this as a team. And that means you, me, all of us together. There's no other way. To know more about the program and details of the department and its functions, you can visit our website. From the website, you can download all our indigenous standards free of cost.
The BIS e-governance portal, Manak Online, provides a comprehensive view of its activities, including on standardization. This portal serves BIS Technical Committee members and also other users of Indian standards. Filters to view the aspect-wise Indian standards classified based on test methods, product specifications, codes of practices, etc. is also available. The list of Indian standards relevant to various ministries and departments can also be accessed online. Details of published Indian standards and draft standards open for public commenting are also available. Proposals can also be submitted through the portal to make new Indian standards. Details about the technical committees, members, and their affiliations through Manak Online are just one click away.
Thank you so much for watching this section of BIS Talks. We will meet again.